Homelessness is among the top COVID-19 related issues causing our community some concern right now. That's according to the latest Fairfax KSAT Rivard Report poll. 10% of those polled said they were worried about homelessness and they want the local government to help. For several weeks, a group of registered nurses consisting of grad students, undergraduates, and faculty from the University of the Incarnate Word have been helping take care of the homeless population at the Haven for Hope Overflow Clinic inside a downtown hotel. They say everyone deserves care and respect, regardless of social status.
You should be treated the same way, regardless of whether you're homeless or not. So we treat everyone the same way. It doesn't matter. They're no different than anyone else. They just need someone to care for them, and we're here to do that.
Good for them. The nurses say they expect the healthcare system to change dramatically once this pandemic is over, and they're preparing to adapt. Now to more results from the latest Fairfax KSAT Rivard Report poll. Tonight, our Steve Spreester was joined by San Antonio Mayor Ron Nuremberg, Bexar County Judge Nelson Wolf, and a panel of community leaders for a town hall style discussion about the community's biggest concerns during the COVID-19 pandemic. Let's take a look.
Welcome to the start of our virtual Fairfax KSAT Rivard Report poll virtual town hall. The requirements for the face coverings for anybody above 10. That was not required in the state order. How do you reconcile those things?
It's in the orders that you have to wear a mask. And businesses have the ability to require masks when you walk in. So let's protect one another and do what the CDC and every public health professional who's looking at this virus has told us is the smart thing to do. Wear a mask if you're going to come within 6 feet of somebody that's not in your house.
Citizens would be a lot more comfortable if we were in a state where the top municipal officials and the governor were working in concert and the governor was not acting unilaterally. And he has put together that advisory committee, which includes five leading individuals from San Antonio. And I hope going forward, there's a little bit more collaboration. I think we'd be well served by that.
27% also said that they felt hopeful. And 25% said that they felt fortunate. And I just think that that's a remarkable statement about San Antonio, that amongst all of the craziness that's going on, that people still feel hopeful and fortunate.
Crime in February, in the February poll we did, was the number one concern. That has kind of dropped down now,
right?
And homelessness is now the number one concern.
This is a huge challenge for shelter in place orders, because obviously we have some of the access points for shelters closed off to maintain social distancing. So we've set up different services around the city where we know encampments are to provide not just food and other essentials, but also to screen people, to identify any vectors for disease and get people into testing and treatment if necessary. And then things like the digital divide. What has been made abundantly clear to me is that if you don't have consistent access to the internet, where we thought it was a luxury maybe 5, 6, 7 years ago, your child's not going to school.
Let's end with that. Like the things that people are most looking forward to, and I want to get to that poll. Socializing with friends and family, 26%. Eating out, 14%. Exercising, 11%. Going back to work, 10%. Attending religious services, 7%.
If you'll just do the reasonable thing and don't listen to some of these people that are telling you this is we don't have a problem, you don't have to wear a face mask, you don't have to stay 6 foot away. Those messages are counterproductive and really hurting us. But do the right things, we'll work our way through it, we'll get the economy to come back, and we're gonna do everything we can to bring prosperity.
Poll results were released yesterday through a partnership between Fairfax, KSAT 12, and the Rivard Report. Right now, you can visit KSAT.com to see those results, as well as outcomes from our first poll earlier this year. coronavirus has now killed more than 60,000 people in the United States, and now a possible glimmer of hope in the form of a treatment. While the Trump administration continues its mission to accelerate development of a coronavirus vaccine, a possible game changer in the recovery process. Remdesivir is an experimental antiviral drug that's not approved to treat anything at all, but it's being touted by some with optimism by Dr. Anthony Fauci, a key member of the White House Coronavirus Task Force. He says it's shown promising results in early trials.
The data shows that remdesivir has a clear-cut, significant, positive effect in diminishing the time to recovery.
The FDA is already planning to issue emergency authorization for the drug, according to the New York Times, but the World Health Organization says it's just too early to tell how effective it is. Turning to some of today's top stories, Vice President Mike Pence taking heat after flouting safety policies when he visited the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota yesterday. He was not wearing a face mask during his tour, even when meeting with a recovered COVID-19 patient who was donating plasma. Reporters at the scene said everybody but Pence had their faces covered. Mayo's policy requires a face mask, which is based on White House guidelines. But President Trump said those guidelines are not mandatory. A spokeswoman for Pence said Wednesday it was not a mistake for him to forego wearing a mask at the Mayo Clinic. Hundreds of fake Facebook accounts have now been linked to President Trump's political advisor, Roger Stone. The revelation comes as the Justice Department made public dozens of search warrants from its investigation into Stone. The documents show Stone's assistant said part of his work for Stone included buying, quote, a couple hundred fake Facebook accounts. The assistant then said bloggers would use the accounts to push information about 2016 Russian hacking and WikiLeaks. Stone said in a statement the newly released documents showed, quote, baseless overreach of the Mueller witch hunt, end quote, and therefore exonerated him. PayPal is letting people cash their paper stimulus checks for free. It usually charges a 1% fee or a minimum of $5 for cashing government or payroll checks. The move lets people cash the checks while staying at home and avoiding a trip to the bank during the pandemic. PayPal says it's waiving those fees until May 31st. If you have to, you can take photos of the front and back of your check through the PayPal app to access the cash. PayPal then reviews it for approval.
What's up, guys? Time to check out some stories that are trending tonight on KSAT.com. And we start with the San Antonio Zoo. They, of course, have been closed for a while due to the coronavirus pandemic, but they are doing something that's really interesting this weekend. They are having a drive-through zoo experience. So what they're doing is that they are allowing people to actually be in their vehicles and drive through the entire zoo. And they have it all kind of mapped out. You get to see all sorts of different exhibits. They have a restroom area. They have a snack stations along the route as well. So you're gonna get to see all your zoo favorites, you know, Africa Live, the Big Cat exhibit, all sorts of different things, the Amazonia exhibit. So it's gonna be a pretty interesting experience. It's called Drive Through Zoo. And I like their tagline here. It says, lions, tigers, and bears, let's drive. So again, this is taking place this weekend at the San Antonio Zoo. They have been hit obviously pretty hard by the pandemic, have not had any visitors. So this will be a cool way for you guys to go out there and experience the San Antonio Zoo once again from the comfort of your vehicle. So check out this story on our website, KSAT.com. All right, speaking of stuff opening up, yesterday we posted a story about all the movie theaters that were not gonna immediately reopen after Governor Abbott announced that the state's stay-at-home order would expire. But it turns out we are gonna have a few options here, including Santikos. The San Antonio-based company announced today that they are gonna open up 3 of their 9 theaters. So this is pretty interesting. They have a whole game plan on how they're gonna do social distancing. People are gonna be seated every other row. They're gonna sell seats in pairs. And if you've been to some of these theaters, which include the Palladium, Casablanca, and the Cibolo Theater, then you know that these, they already have the recliners. So that's already kind of keeping people separate. So they're doing all these different measures. Of course, concessions will all be done differently. It's a whole different thing. And they're actually gonna open up Saturday. And it should be pretty fun. They are gonna show movies that were supposed to be on when they close. So we've been already talking about a lot of movies that have been delayed or pushed back. So we won't see any of those, but we will get to get the movie theater experience. It's gonna be a lot of fun. If you want more information, check out the details on our website. And again, three Santikos theaters opening that, and we also have Evo opening up too. So keep that in mind, that one up there in shirts. All right, last story of our day. And this one's a pretty interesting one. Of course, a lot of people, reporters, news people working from home. Well, there was a reporter, an ABC reporter, who actually went on air. He was wearing a suit coat and everything, but he didn't realize that the camera showed that he was not wearing any pants. Not wearing any pants. Good times there. So this reporter, Will Reeve, did a live shot on Good Morning America, and basically as he was closing out the live shot, he panned the camera and it showed that he did not have pants on. Now, he took it all in stride. I'm pretty sure he was pretty freaked out, and he said that this experience gave him an opportunity to arrive to America in the most hilariously mortifying way possible. So feel kind of bad for the guy, but at the same time, he turned it into something of a joking moment. If you want to check out this story, you could go to our website, ksat.com. And don't worry, I'm not gonna pan the camera down to see, but I'm good, don't worry about that. He did also say that he was wearing shorts, so for people that were concerned about that whole thing, he was wearing shorts. If you want the full story here and you wanna check out more of our website, go to ksat.com. You guys have a great night and stay safe.
Thank you so much for watching the news at 9. Don't forget, the Night Beat starts at 10. See you then.